Good morning. Hello, everyone. Today is, I should always think about this before I turn the camera on, and then I always forget to think about it, and then once it's on, I forget what day it is. Okay, I think it's day 11. Yeah, it's day 11. VLCD 11. And I was very surprised this morning to see that I had another 2-pound release. So that brings my total to 13.1, and I'm now at, as of this morning, 201.3, I think it was, 201.2. So that's where I am, and that's exciting. I think a lot of it had to do with the fact that yesterday was a really bad day. Not bad HCG wise or diet wise. It was bad, just bad. Briefly, I'll tell you what happened. I was just really devastated because I'm a good person. I'm fair with people, and I just seem to have had a streak of people come into my life that are really bad people who, really betray me, stab me in the back, hurt me. I'm not talking about relationship crap or anything like that. I'm talking about, you know, professionals, a client, people that, you know, it wasn't like that where there would be all these feelings involved and mixed up, but, you know, people you just didn't expect. So anyway, yesterday what happened was, I've been using the same accountant for 4 years now, and every year I do the same thing. I file an extension, I get all my stuff together, I send it to her with my categorizations, she plugs it all in, she sends me my tax return, she charges me $350, this is for my business, and I have a very small business, one part-time employee, and then myself, and some subcontractors, so it's not like it's a big deal. There's been a shadow or something on my phone. I can't tell what that is. Anyway, maybe it's just the lighting. Anyway, so same thing happens this year. And she sends me my tax return yesterday along with her invoice. And this year, she decided instead of charging me $350, she would charge me $1,850. Yes, $1,850. So, I'm like, what the hell is happening here? I mean, this can't be right. This is insane. So, I was going into session, so I had my secretary call and say, you know, basically, what the hell? And she said, well, that's for 2011 bookkeeping. She's like, you don't do our bookkeeping. We don't do that. She's like, well, but I go through your check register. She's like, but you go through our check register every year. You've always done that. Yeah, but I've not been charged her for it, and I needed to start doing that. Hello? Okay, so, you know, I'm a layperson when it comes to accounting. So I don't know what a normal thing is to need for a tax return. I just know what my CPA tells me. And based on what my CPA tells me, that's what I do. And based on what I've paid, I do the same thing every year, expecting the same results from that. And this year she decides to just charge me for something that she can label as bookkeeping because she went through my check register, even though my secretary actually my glasses are rattling in here. Actually, my secretary had gone through the check register herself and had pulled out several of the checks, the majority of the checks, and categorized them already. So I don't know why she didn't do them all. I don't know, but whatever. I mean, she did the majority of them that were tedious, like all my subcontractors and stuff like that. So, but it was the same thing she's done for 3 years. It's the exact same MO, exact same thing. And also, you know, I should have fired her a long time ago because every year she has screwed something up. She's given me diarrhea every year, I swear to God. by, you know, 1 year sending me something saying, okay, you know, your taxes are $22,000 this year. And I'm like, what? And it turned out that she didn't get my list of categorizations, which was a $60,000 expense. She didn't take off my property tax. She didn't take off my HSA. Blah, 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 blah. Ended up, I got a refund that year. So, and then I caught a mistake last year that I ended up getting $1,100 back when she filed an amendment, because I caught the mistake after the fact when I was comparing my 2010 to my 2009. I caught it on my 2009 that had been filed, where she claimed my HSA was a non-medical expenditures. So I had to not only pay 25% tax on it, but a 10% penalty. So I should have fired her then, but I don't like change. And I'm pretty good at catching her mistakes. She's always losing things when we fax it to her, but whatever. But this pissed me off, because I also felt like I trusted her. You know, not trusted her necessarily that she's always going to get everything right, she's always going to be on top of things, but that she had integrity, that she wasn't going to screw me over, that she was a good person. That's what I trusted. And that's what's so disappointing, is that, once again, it's somebody that people don't have to earn my trust. They really don't. I give it to them. And I'm not naive about it, but I just can't stand it when they trample on it. So it was a bad day. I mean, I lost it at work. I broke down. An old subcontractor called me, which she hasn't called me in over a year, and she just caught me at the wrong time, and she could tell. She's a therapist, we all know. So I'm like, hello, and she said, are you okay? And I'm like, you know, I start bawling on the phone like a baby, and, you know, but that helped. It was good timing. She's a good person. I can trust her. It's funny, her resume stood out to me, and one of the reasons that I wanted to hire her was because her name was spelled like mine. Actually, my name is spelled J-E-A-N-A, Gina. So it's not G-I-N-A. And her name is spelled J-E-A-N-A. So I wanted to really like her, and I did, and hired her, and it worked out great for a while. But then she just wasn't making enough money and had to get a full-time job and get benefits. So that's too bad. I miss her. It's hard. Now I'm about to go to the office to go into a meeting with a client and another subcontractor, who has really been screwing up and who I think is taking money. And this subcontractor is seeing this client's daughter. I'm seeing the client, she's seeing the client's daughter. And there have been boundary crossings and all kinds of crap that I now have to deal with that. And it's a list of 19 things that my client has compiled to confront her on. Some of those very, very backstabbing things to me, where she has said things behind my back that my client has disclosed to me and told me, but until now has not felt comfortable enough or ready to confront her. And it was hard for me to confront her because, you know, well, I needed her there to say, no, you did say that, because she'll lie. So it's just like, really, really. So all of that being said, I think that's part of why I lost the 2 pounds, because I lose weight when I get stressed. I couldn't eat very much yesterday. I did eat dinner, but I couldn't eat lunch because I was at work sobbing, and so I couldn't eat lunch. But I ate a good dinner. I had some lettuce wraps with the chicken thing that I made from Kim's recipe. It was really good, and that's all I had. And I did get my water in, so that was good. But I knew I would probably drop some because I could just feel it. I just knew. So I'm not upset over it, but not the way I want to lose it. You know, I don't want to lose it because I'm so stressed out that I want to curl up in a ball. I'm just tired of it. And there's more people to add to that list, but those are, you know, the top two as of today. And it's just hard when you're a good person and you, for whatever reason, you know, it's not karma. I know it's not, because I haven't pissed anybody off to that extent, but God, it just keeps biting me in the ass. I'm tired of it. So anyway, that's my rant for today. It helps to get it out. If I talked yesterday about this, I would have cried on here and you wouldn't have understood. I would have had the ugly face cry. So I thought I'd wait till today. I don't know what the shadow is. I'll try to fix that. But Thanks for listening. Talk to you later. Bye.